Hi, Stan with 3D PT. Recently I saw a video, a friend tagged me in on a technique where you print 3D printed rigid filament over a layer of fabric. And when you pull it off, it gives you a layer of flexibility that you can't get with rigid filaments. And they printed some scales in their video, and I'll provide a link in the blog at 3dprinterchat.com. And 3D printing on fabric is not a new technique. I've seen it done in the past over like t-shirts where you can print like logos and things. I've always wanted to do a filament, a print like that with flexible filament like NinjaFlex, which is a thermoplastic urethane or TPU. And so I just finished my about second test, so let me pull that over. And so yes, I did print with flexible material. This is through the Moore, Lesbot Moore extruder. Some people were asking me if you could do flexible through it. Same trick I did with the Lesbot 5. With the standard extruder, you just stick a piece of filament in it, and it lets you print flexible through it. But the cool thing is, you can print flexible material. And I did a test earlier. Now, best way I found is just to put the t-shirt straight on the build plate. It did wobble a little bit, so I'd recommend either a lot more clips or use some double-sided tape. So let's pull this off, see how it looks. The first print I did didn't turn out really well. I actually tried printing over a base first, like the video said, but that didn't work. Is the finished result. So the idea is to use this as a jar opener. And all the pieces are very well stuck into it. And so you can kind of see here. The impression on the back. And they're all stuck firmly into this. And this is pretty cool. I'm going to make a different design. But yeah, you can print with flexible material on flexible on a like an old t-shirt or other material. So this time I changed up the design a bit, and I noticed when I was printing sometime in the earlier print, the fabric shifted in the center. So I actually found some double-sided tape and I put that down, and that actually secures it real well. And so it's still printing in NinjaFlex, and this already looks a lot better, a lot smoother. So if you want to start by using the base layer first, you'll have to play around with that. But the layer height on this is set to 0.9 millimeters. So it could take some, it has some room for the filament to come out. And yeah, cool. Made mine a little bit thicker than I like, but yeah, it's a prototype. So I'm gonna pull it off now. Had a little fun printing this one up. So maybe make it into a little bando, something like that. Actually, that's pretty flexible, and it's nice because it does bend around. Yeah, who knows? So this could be another application, maybe making bandanas or something with, at very least, like decorations on them, but maybe putting some shock absorber, so then that way you could wear it with like a helmet. There's some applications there. Yes, it's still a little warm. NinjaFlex, I printed at about 240°C. But yeah, this is actually pretty comfortable. It fits just like a t-shirt. On the back side, you can see how it kind of soaked into this. And it was a little bit around the edge. I don't know if you could really see that. But what's cool is it's completely flexible. And if I grab it on this side, it's got a nice fabric touch, so it gives me a little more grip. 3D printed hard hat. So I made a second test where I actually 3D printed over some denim that I found in my house. And so I decided to experiment by printing a wallet. And so this printed in two parts on one sheet of fabric, like so. And the idea is that this folds up and closes up and you have your wallet. And this is a Slim's men's wallet, so it's designed to not be uncomfortable on, because most men sit on their wallet in their rear pocket, which they shouldn't. But this way, it fits. It's nice and slim, and this is only about, I think I measured it at 23 millimeters thick. So it's a lot thinner than some of the other wallets, leather wallets that men wear. And this edge is semi-flex and it gives the fabric support and lets it slide in and out of your pocket easily. And being fabric, this breathes a lot better so you don't get a sweaty spot on your pants and doesn't chew up your pockets as much. And inside it's got two slots to hold your cards. And so overall it's a very flexible design. So it bends with you a lot easier than a heavy leather wallet would. So I'm gonna hold off on publishing these just now, but I'm gonna publish a blog on how to print over this material. And like I said, this is actual blue jean denim. So we had some decide to print that.